On today's Shopify tutorial, we're gonna go over how to add Shopify apps. Let's get into it. So the first thing you wanna do here is just head over to apps, which is right here. And then you walk to this purple button where it says visit the Shopify App Store. Also, if you see right here, I only have one app installed, which is product reviews. You probably don't have anything if you're a brand new store, but this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna find some apps that we can install on this store. Now, a good rule of thumb is not to go crazy just installing every single app out there. They might make your store load a little bit slower just because your website has to reach out to all these APIs and all these JavaScript files in order to load up all these apps on your store, on your website. So be careful about the type of ads that you add to your store. And even if you're testing something, I would definitely just be cautious of just adding everything, anything right here on the App Store. There is a lot of free apps out here. There's also some apps that are designed by Shopify, which are, I would say almost all of them are free or close to free. And then there's also a bunch of apps from, you know, people from other countries and other other places. So again, just be careful about the type of ads that you're adding. Make sure that you go through reviews. Let's just see one of these apps over here. For example, Return Magic. This is one that's made by Shopify. And actually not made by Shopify, it's made by alveo.io. But it makes it super easy for you to, or for your customers to return items to your store. So the typical app page will look something like this. It will have the amount of reviews, the average ratings. It will have a video explaining what the app is all about. It will give you some talking points here. It will also show you the full description of everything this app can do. And it will also give you some screenshots, which I do like the screenshots because you actually get to see how this will look on your store, and you get to see a little bit of the back end, which is also important when installing apps. Now, very important, I said a lot of apps are free, but also a lot of them are paid. So you want to pay attention to the pricing. So for example, this one is $10 a month, and this bill gets added to your regular Shopify bill. So once you add this, it will just get added to the, if you're on the basic, to the $29 that you already pay, plus any shipping labels that you create on top of, you know, any apps that you have. So again, just be very careful with the amount of apps, because every app has, not every app, but every paid app has some sort of pricing in there that will add every single month. If we keep scrolling down, the next thing we'll see is all the reviews. Again, you wanna make sure that you go over some of these reviews, make sure that everything looks good. And once you're ready to install the app, all you have to do is click on add app. And this might take a minute, but this will automatically install the app on your store. So I would say 90% of the apps, you also see this page. And then right here, we'll just click on install app. I would say 90% of the apps, you don't have to do anything additional, but there are some where it requires to go through a installation process. So even though you've added the app, it might ask you to insert a piece of code on your cart, for example, or somewhere else within the code. But even though they ask you to do that, some of them also provide installation support where you just pay them a flat fee of like, I don't know, $5, $15. And they take care of installing the app for you, which is kind of cool. So looks like this one kind of froze a little bit, but not to worry. We'll just go back over here, refresh this page. We'll see if it's in here. So you see, it's already installed and it's in here. Again, you want to make sure that you click on it to make sure that there's no other additional steps that you need to do in order to install the app on your store. And beyond that, it's just a matter of going through the app settings, making sure that everything is set up correctly how you want it. And that's about it. I mean, that's how you add apps to the store. To get rid of apps, now that's a different story. You definitely have to go through one by one, and they each individual app have, I guess, uninstall instructions. So to install the app is usually pretty easy. To uninstall them might be a little bit more cumbersome because the app automatically adds different code to different parts of the website. So when you're getting rid of it, you have to go through their documentation to make sure that you uninstall it correctly and that there's no old code within your store left in there, which is just bogs down the website. All right, that's it for today. All right, if you enjoyed this episode, make sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and also make sure to subscribe. We have a goal of 1,000 subscribers. If we haven't hit it yet, make sure you subscribe to help us reach that goal. See ya.